Demonetization, in my opinion, is the cruelest attack on the people by the present government. They said that they will capture black money, curb black money, and curb terrorist money, bring out fake currency, and also weed out corruption. But none of the four objectives that has been proclaimed by this government have been fulfilled. In fact, the Prime Minister himself said, just wait for 50 days. If my intention is proved wrong, if my objectives are proved wrong, I am prepared to undergo any punishment that people are ready to give. But now, entire thing has become a total failure. 99.3% of the currency has already been into the circulation as per the report of the Reserve Bank of India. That 10,000 crores that is left out is also there in the form of a old currency in quotes and currency from Bhutan, Nepal, etc. And also money that could not be deposited in the banks by the ordinary people after 1st January 2017. Because the government suddenly changed its earlier announcement that people can deposit money in Reserve Bank of India. That announcement was changed. So money is left out. So entire currency, 100% currency has been into the circulation, and the demonetization is a total failure. Actually, the demonetization has paralyzed the banking industry for almost 5 months. From November 8th to 31st March 2017, the banking activities came to a standstill. They could not do anything. They could not lend afresh. They could not recover the money. Thereby, the banking industry was actually put behind its earlier position because of the demonetization. Again, during demonetization, the number of man hours lost. Crores and crores of people were made to stand between 4 to 9 to 10 hours during demonetization. The man hours lost will be several crores. And people have lost jobs because the small industries also perished because of demonetization, particularly in Tirupur, Nasik, Surat. So many hundreds and thousands of people have lost jobs. One study says 15 lakhs people have lost jobs, and it is something more than that also. And about 112 people lost their lives. A small child which went for some treatment in a hospital owned by the then minister of the central cabinet minister, central minister. And that hospital did not give any treatment to the small infant because they had only demonetized currency. They did not have the currency that was worthy at that point of time after November 8, 2016. And one man killed his wife in Bengal just because she could not change the old notes into new notes after standing in the queue for 6 to 8 hours. Like that, hundreds of people died. This government did not pay even homage to these people. And bank employees died. When the currency van, after depositing money in the chest, it met with an accident and 7 people died. A cashier died on the spot in Pune. And another subordinate staff died because of the work pressure. And one person in Karnataka committed suicide, suspecting something about him in the that was in the newspaper, like that. So this government did not bother about the ordinary people at all. The Reserve Bank of India was sought its opinion only a day before, and it has been revealed through RTI now that Reserve Bank board met only just 2.5 hours at 5:30 p.m. before the announcement of the demonetization. And in that board meeting also, it is the 561st meeting of the Reserve Bank. The minutes reveal that Reserve Bank did not support any of the claims of the government of India. The Reserve Bank report minutes very clearly state that the black money cannot be curbed because of the demonetization, because a large portion of the black money is in the form of gold and real estate and not in the form of cash. That was the number one observation of the Reserve Bank of India. Secondly, Reserve Bank said the fake currency is estimated only 400 crores compared to 15,41,000 crores. 400 crores is nothing, but it is a pittance. For that, demonetization should not be resorted to. And also, the Reserve Bank warned that if demonetization is resorted to, people coming from abroad, people in the tourism, and people seeking medical aid, all these people will be put to untold hardships. And despite all these things, after telling all these things, Reserve Bank succumbed to the pressure of the Government of India. But the actual minutes of Reserve Bank of India were signed by the then governor only on 15th December 2016, after 37 days of implementation of demonetization. There are a lot of court cases going on that at that point of time. Several high courts, move of the government was challenged. And ultimately, everything was brought to Supreme Court. Still, Supreme Court has not taken up that agenda at all. Whether at all government has got a power to demonetize is a fundamental question that was raised. And it has not been answered at all till today. And there are the litigation is going on. And as far as the demonetization is concerned, as per the report of the economists, and particularly the Prime Minister, Mr. Manmohan Singh, the economy of the country has been reduced by about 1.5 to 2% of the GDP has been affected. Thereby, about 3 lakh crores has been lost. And for printing new notes, 8,000 crores was spent. And the Reserve Bank has spent 31,000 crores on account of demonetization. And the money that has not reached the Reserve Bank of India is hardly 10,000 crores. Assuming that it is actual figure, the money that has been spent for demonetization activities, 40 to 50,000 crores of rupees. Demonetization is a total failure and it is a cruelest attack on the common man of the country.